Good evening friends, this is GV Shokumar again. So today topic I like to discuss about the different phases of SAP Activate methodology. Okay, so as everybody know, actually SAP Activate methodology is a new approach for carrying out any projects and delivering SAP innovations and solutions, right? So being built on the agile methodology, so agile is an iterative process, right? It's an iterative method of project management and software developments that supports team in providing value to their clients more quickly with less stress in a quick manner, right? The time also is minimum. So the SAP Active methodology employs an iterative process to continually deliver and improve efficiency of transformation in order to enhance the quality and project success. Okay, and the first step for any project to identify and define the appropriate roadmap, post which SAP teams and consultants will progress through six different phases in agile methodology, that is called SAP Activate methodology. SAP Activate methodology is based out of SAP Agile, right? So based on your you can realize the business pain points, everything. So each touch point defined offers a distinct milestone in the process of helping clients through the SAP implementation life cycle and choosing the best option to a particular client requirement. So there are six different phases, that is discover, prepare, explore, realize, deploy and run. So what are the activities you perform in discover? So finding the solution capabilities, comprehending or its commercial values and benefits for your company, and choosing an adaption plan and timeline that is in line with the solution capabilities and the product roadmap at the or the time are the primary goals of the discovery phases. Customer often access trial environments during this stage to gain practical experience with application and help with the selection process. What are the key deliverables in the discover phase? Means the planning, the transformation strategy, and then application value, scoping analysis, access to the trial system, that is demo system, and discovery assessment. So important four key deliverables are planning, the transformation strategy, application value, and the scoping analysis, access to the trial systems, and discovery assessment. So these are the four important key deliverables in discover phase. When coming to the next one, prepare phase, the project's initial planning and preparation began during this prepare phase. At this point, the project has already been initiated, the blueprints have been drafted, and the project team resource have been assigned, and actual work on the project has begun. Additionally, during this phase, phase of the project, so the basic technical and application environment is furnished to set up. So what are the key deliverables in the prepare phase? Means project team, that is project team enablement, that is self enablement, project initiation, project governance. Normally in PMP you came to know project initiations and everything, right? Project code initiation, those kind of activities, similar activity that is specific to agile methodology, SAP agile projects. And project governance, plan, project schedule and budget, project kickoff, then project standoff, standards and infrastructures, devising the standards and infrastructure, initial environment provision, setup and activation of best practices, OCM roadmap, organization change management roadmap, and access to implementation supporting tools, fit to standardization preparation, including system preparation, functionality, data, everything, and then authorizations, roles and responsibility mapping, data migration strategy, testing strategy and approach, and end user learning strategy, and phase closure and sign off. Right? These are the phases of prepare phase in the agile methodology project management, activate project management. And then we are coming to the explore phase. So the explore phase goal is to establish the configuration values, necessary extensions and analytics need while doing the fit to standard study to check the solution standard functionality fits with your business client business needs. The explore phase also entitles the developing the identity and access management, identifying necessary integrations and determining data requirements. Data requirements and configuration values are noted and added to the list of the explore phase. So the project team begins assembling a learning team as a part of the adaption works team, which oversees the OCM and end user enablement activities, as well as preparing for the execution of data migration activities, testing plans and team building during the explore phase. So what are the key deliverables, right? In that phase, we have execution and monitoring of the project, fit to standard analysis, and company execution of standard process, and solution design, and integration planning and design, extension planning and design, and analytical planning and design. And we have then identity and access management planning and design, and data load preparation, testing plan, test planning, mobilization of learning team, and phase closure and sign up. Okay, these are the activities in the explore phase. And now we have the realize phase. Realize phase, what you will do? So based on the business scenario and process requirement discovered during the fit to standard analysis or workshops in the explore phase, you will use a sequence of agile iterations to incrementally create or test or and verify an integrated business and system environments in the realize phase. Planning operations in the new environment, conducting adoption adoption task and loading company data, all are included in this phase. What are the key deliverables when achieving a realization phase? So similar to the earlier phases, right, we have set of deliverables, key deliverables allotted for the realization phase. So what are they? So execution and monitoring of the project, and then OCM integration activities, initial access and setup of development environment, especially in SAP S/4HANA cloud, and initial access and setup of test environment in SAP S/4HANA cloud, configuration and solution documentation, setup of integrations, development and setup of solution extensibility, setup and setup of output management and printing, legacy data migration activities, and execution of unit and string testing in sprints, and solution walkthrough in each sprint, technical walkthrough or technical operations and handover, solution walkthrough in each sprint, that is very important. So normally actually we have scrum of scrums, means actually all the different scrum teams are forming together or grouping together to discuss on the updates or plan everything. That is called a scrum of scrum. Okay, and setup and output management and printing, everything I told, and then actually solution walkthrough in each sprint, and technical operations and handover, and planning of center of expertise, that is COE, or the operational support, and development of key user enablement materials, and development of end user training and documentation, preparation and execution of integration testing, and preparation and execution of UAT, and cutover planning, and then phase closure and sign off, optional activation of additional scope items when needed, and system upgrade that is optional and relevant especially for planning for the cloud solution deployment. Okay, when coming to a deploy phase, right, in deploy phase goals, goals include establishing the production environment, right, production environment, ensuring organization preparedness, and transitioning a business process to operate in a new environment. So what are the key deliverables? So the key deliverable, in the sense, we have set of responsibilities to be covered in the deploy phase. So execution and monitoring of the project, execution and of organization change activity. See, this execution and monitoring of the project is will be available in each phase that is more responsible or more critical in all the phases. And execution of OCM activities also, organization change management also very important. And end user learning delivery, that is important. And then dress rehearsal and production cutover, operational readiness, hypercare support, and then stabilization of production environment after cutover and handover to support organization. So to the application management services, right? That is a part of, I can say, the deploy phase. And now we are coming to the final phase, so-called run. After go live, after a business go live, then we have, there is an unscripted phase called run. That is not encountered, but we need to encounter. That is a support phase, production support. In ASAP methodology, we are calling as post-go-live support, right? Its goal is to make sure the solution is operating at its best efficiency and to benefit from the frequent updates. SAP publishes for the SAP S/4HANA cloud environment. It, in accordance with the requirements of your organization, this phase also emphasizes the ongoing adoption of the solution by the new users. What are the key deliverables? That is ongoing system operations, continuous OCM activities, continuous learning, continuous business process and system governance improvements, new scope activities activation, new country or countries activation, setup, onboarding new users, system upgrades, all these things. So actually the project manager is considered as a full scrum team, is a screen, a team of full satisfied scrum team is a main person. And actually we have actually in the scrum methodologies we have a product owner. Scrum product owner is a kind of a manager or something like a AGM, GM from the business, who is taking care of functional process. And the scrum lead actually is nothing but actually I can say agile scrum, right? Scrum master is nothing but a person actually who is a IT manager or a lead kind of role, which is active. He is acting as a interface between the or a bridge between the business user group and product owner and with the IT team. So we have different set of tools actually. For actually, the tools available in the SAP S/4HANA Agile methodology or Activate methodology based out of Agile roadmap. So the operating policy a little bit differs from the on-premise and the cloud deployment. Okay, so and we have actually say the Agile, what Activate methodology will give benefit is you can maintain a small team of expertise team, and no need to actually, if it is a cloud, then actually no need for a basis consultant or no need for the physical transport of movements, because all the developments and everything will be done by the SAP in cloud. And on-premise only we need the basis consultant, and actually we need to do transports and everything, and in our cloud actually everything will be pushed by SAP through your cloud. So when you are handling a public cloud or a private cloud, depends on your interest, right? Client's interest and in negotiation with SAP. So you cannot directly develop any solution when it is in cloud, right? So there is no need for an ABAP consultant or developer kind of thing, but we need a theory consultant, functional consultant, and in functional team we need actually minimum one person is enough for that, and we need a scrum master, scrum so a product owner, and then project manager, all these people. And the cost is also very less, and the scrum will be in plan, right? All the sprints will be in plan or the execution in one or two starting phases. After that, there will be a deviation. So whatever actually in the scrums you are pushing, say if it is any delay in execution of a particular sprint activity, that those pending activities will be pushed to the succeeding sprints. And if in case actually you are unable to complete a particular scrum activity, then actually it will be delivered after the post go live activity, that is after run also possible. So that is not a depend like ASAP methodology. All the phases are interdependent, and what it's a kind of waterfall, right? The previous output of previous phase output will be the input to the succeeding phase, but in Agile it is not like that. So actually the time required for executing a project is also less, and this is suitable for minimum time projects, say maximum 3 to 4 months. Actually you can able to complete the project, and whatever the backlog or anything actually you can execute after the run phase or during the run phase. So I can say the how the backlog is is sorted out based on the business priority. So the Agile methodology is used for it's a methodology to run end-to-end project life cycle, and Scrum team is required to monitor the progress of the project. So all these things are very important. Actually we are having different Scrum process in place, so that will help you to guide how to device your Agile Scrum process and everything. So I hope what the details have given here is very useful. So as a part of final conclusion, SAP Activate offers through a list of project deliverables along with step-by-step instructions on how to prepare and complete each sprint or each one. For each phase and work stream, the methodology also offers accelerators, which could be a document and resources like templates, questionnaires, checklist, how to guide and manuals. So please keep in mind, the goal is to make your implementation more effective, reliable and repeatable. So in case of actually conversion or a migration project, the I can say in a realization phase, the configuration development is a kind of actually changing the customized process. So it's not a big deal, right? Like a greenfield implementation. So these are the basic concepts I like to share in the Activate methodology of different phases. So here important thing, as already told, we have 6 phases in the Active methodology, that is discover, prepare, explore, realize, deploy and run. So those we have discussed in detail and elaborately in my video. Thanks for watching my videos. This is GB Shivakumar signing off.